In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a procedural particle logo animation in After Effects without using a single plugin. Let's get to it. So here we are in After Effects. I'm going to start by creating a new composition. It will be 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, 8 seconds for the duration. Click OK. Then drag the logo to the timeline and press S on a keyboard to adjust the scale of it if needed. I'll slightly decrease mine. Then right-click on the logo and select Precompose. Name it Logo. And make sure Move All Attributes is checked, then click OK. Then open Effects and Presets window and search for Shader. Then add it to the logo composition. Then head over to the Effect Controls panel and set View to Rendered so we can see what's happening. Now let's move a bit forward on the timeline so we can see the effect. And I'm going to expand these settings because we're going to adjust them one by one as we go. So first I'm going to set Pattern to be Glass. Then Repetitions 200, that's the maximum we can go. Then extrusion depth to 0, no extrusion on this. Then in the force 1, I'm going to click on this position icon and place it all the way to the bottom in the middle, like this. Then I'm going to set the radius to be 0.5 and strength to 1. Now I'm going to set the rotation speed to 0.25, tumble axis to none, randomness 0.25, viscosity 0.25, mass variance 0, gravity also 0.25. And gravity direction to 0, so the particles will shoot up. So now if we do the preview, this is what we have. So the particles look like glass, but we're going to change that in just a bit. Now, we're going to create the gradient map to drive this animation. It will be a lot easier to control it this way. For that, we're going to go up to Layer, New, Solid, click OK. Then in Effects and Presets, we're going to search for Ramp and add the gradient ramp to the solid layer. Then search for Turbulent Displace. And also add it to the solid layer. And here all we have to do is to set complexity to 10 to get this kind of texture. Now I'm going to place the solid below the logo and hide it because we don't need to see it. Then select the logo composition and go back to the effect controls panel. In the gradient settings, we're going to set the gradient layer to be the solid that we created. Instead of source, we're going to set it to effects and masks. And now what this will allow us to do is we can control the whole animation by dragging the threshold of the shader. So if I increase it, you can see that we're getting this effect. So I'm going to move the time indicator all the way to the start of the timeline and set the shader threshold to 0 and create a keyframe by clicking on the stopwatch. Then I'll move 5 seconds forward and I'll set it to 100. So now if we do the preview, and this might be a bit heavy, so you could drop like to half resolution. And if we do the preview, this is what we get. And in this case, I want the animation to start from this top and go to the bottom. And for that, I'm just going to check the invert gradient box. Now the animation will start from the top and the particles will shoot upwards. Now I'm going to search for CC vector blur in effects and presets and add it to the logo composition. Now I'm going to set the type to be perpendicular and set the amount to 12. So this will give the particles a liquidy kind of look, which looks cool. And then I'm going to search for sharpen and also add it to the logo composition, then set the sharpen amount to 50 to make the particles a bit brighter and more defined. So this is all coming together. Now I'm going to add an adjustment layer. So layer, new adjustment layer, make sure it is above all other layers. Then in effects and presets, let's search for glow. And in the stylize, add it to the adjustment layer. Then in effect controls, I'm going to set the glow threshold to be 100 and leave the glow radius to be 10. Then I'm going to select the glow and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. And then in a second glow, I'm going to set the radius to be 1000, so the maximum. And now we have a nice glow effect applied to the logo as well as the particles. And now I'm going to add a slow zoom effect throughout the animation. So let's go all the way to the start of the timeline. Select the logo composition and press S on the keyboard. I'm going to set scale to 110 and then create a keyframe. Then let's move all the way to the end of the timeline and set scale to be 100. And let's also create the fade out of the particles closer to the end. So I'm going to move the time indicator to 5 seconds. Keep the logo composition selected and press T on the keyboard to bring up opacity. Create a keyframe. And let's move 2 seconds forward to 7 seconds. And set opacity to 0. So the particles will fade out closer to the end. At this point, you could add a background. But if you're planning to do so, I suggest you precompose all the layers that you have here. So select all of them. Right-click any of them, precompose. And name this whatever you want, like final, click OK. And then here you're going to add in a solid layer for the background. So layer, new solid, name this one BG, and place it below the logo. Then in effects and presets, I'm going to search for a ramp, add the gradient ramp to the solid layer, and I'm going to move the start and end of ramp to the corners of the composition like this. I'm going to set it to radial ramp, and now let's choose the colors based on the logo, so something like purple, and then make the one a bit darker, so we create like a gradient. And I'm also going to set the ramp scatter to some 25, and after that we can go ahead and preview the animation. So this is our complete particle logo animation created in After Effects without using a single plugin. And the cool thing about this animation is that it is completely procedural. So if we go all the way back to the logo composition and decide to use a different logo, so let me drag and drop a different one. Just make sure you adjust the size so it matches the previous logo's size like this. Then I'm going to hide the previous logo, go back to the render composition. And here if we do the preview, you will see that everything automatically adjusts without you having to do anything. So I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.